मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, आई होप क्लास सिक्स चिल्ड्रेन आर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो. लास्ट डे इफ यू रिमेंबर वी हैड स्टार्टेड एलसीएम एंड एचसीएफ एंड फ्यू सॉल्व क्वेश्चंस ऑलरेडी वी हैड डन. वी लर्नड हाउ टू फाइंड एचसीएफ बाय टू मेथड्स, डिवीजन मेथड एंड प्राइम फैक्टराइजेशन मेथड. टुडे इन कंटिन्यूएशन वी विल सी एक्सरसाइज 2D. ऑलरेडी आई थिंक मेनी ऑफ यू माइट हैव स्टार्टेड एंड In solved examples, many questions already have been solved by seeing that also exercise 2D can be done. But let's see few questions I have, selected question I have taken. Here you see, find the HCF of the numbers in each of the following using the prime factorization method. That is your first question. So how we will solve this? Prime factorization method already you have learned. Here you see first number you have 84. So, what we need to do, we will see the prime number and with prime number we will start dividing. So, first number suppose you have, you take 2 and you must know the divisibility test for these numbers. So, here you have in ones place you have 4, so this must be divisible by 2. So, you divide this number 2, 4 ja 8 and 2, 2 ja 4 again by 2, 2, 2 ja 4, 2, 1 ja 2 and now, by 2 it cannot be divided, so by 3 you take, 3 7 ja 21. So, this 84 can be expressed as, 84 can be expressed as 2 into 2 into 3 into 7, or can be written as 2 square into 3 into 7. Now, you see 98, the same thing is required to be done. 98, you divide this, what you will get? 2 4 ja 8, 2 9 ja 18, 7 7 ja 49. So, 98 can be expressed as 2 into 7 into 7, or it can be written as 2 into 7 square. If you remember, what is HCF? HCF is the product of common factor having least power. So, HCF will be HCF of 84 and 98 will be product of the common factor. First you see common factor you have 2 and 7, 2 and 7. Now, you need to know the least power. Here you have 2 square, here you have nothing, it means 2 to the power 1 you have. So, least power you have 2. So, we have taken, and in 7 you see 7 square and 7, least power you have 7. So, product of this number you need. So, this is 2 into 7 and that is equal to 14, and this is your answer. So, what you need to do? First of all, you need to do prime factorization. That number is required to be expressed, and then you need to see the common factor. Common factor you write down, then you see the least power of those common factor that you see, and then you find the product, and that will be your HCF, that will be your answer. Next question you see, the same thing is there that is required to be solved by prime factorization. So, let us start. 1197. Now, you see by which number this will be divided. So, you must know the divisibility test. Here you see 1 plus 1 is equal to 2 and 2 plus 9 is equal to 11, 11 plus 7 is equal to 18. So, this must be divided by 3, 3 3 is 9 and this will be 3 9 is 27 and 3 9 is 27. Again by 3, 3 1 ja 3, 3 3 ja 9 and 3 3 ja 9. Further, I do not think this will be divisible. So, 1197 can be expressed as 3 into 3 into 133. Second number you take, 5 3 2 0. Now, you see 0 you have. So, either by 2 or by 5 this number should be divisible. Start with 2, 2 2 ja 4, 1 you have, this became 13, 2 6 is 12, 2 6 is 12 and this again 0. Then again 2 1 is 2, 2 3 is 6, 2 3 is 6 and 0. Then you divide by 5 or 2, by 2 also it can be done. Continue with 2 itself. 2 6 is 12, 2 6 is 12, 2 5 is 10. And then you have once place 5, so by 5 it will be divisible. 5 1 is 5, it became 16, 5 3 is 15, and 1 you have, so it became again 15, 5 3 is 15. So this 5 3 2 0 can be expressed as 2 into 2 into 2 into 5 into 133. Now next number you have 4 3 8 9. This you divide. Again you need to see by which number this will be divisible. Here you see 4 plus 3 is equal to 7, 7 plus 8 15, 15 plus 9 is equal to 24. So 24 is divisible by 3, so this number must be divisible by 3. 3 1 is 3, then you have 3 4 is 12, 3 6 is 18 and 3 3 is 9. Again you see 5 and 6 11 and 3 14, so by 3 it will not be divisible. By some other number you see by which number it will be divisible. You try with 11. 11 1 is 11, here you have 3 and 6 36, 11 3 is 33, again 3 is remaining, 3 and 3 33, 11 3 is 33. So now you have factorized, you write down 1197, that can be expressed as 3 into 3 into 133. Or it can be written as 3 square into 133. Next number you have 5320, and this can be expressed as 2 into 2 into 2 into 5 into 133. Or it can be expressed as 2 to the power 3, 3 times you have, into 5 into 133. Next number you have 4389, and this can be expressed as 3 into 11 into 133. So no repetition of number is there, so this number will be same. Now you need to see the common factor in between. In these three numbers you have expressed as prime factors, so you need to see the common factor in between. So common factor you have 133, so your HCF will be, so you will write hence HCF of 1197, 5320 and 4389 will be 133, and this will be your answer. So, in this way these type of questions are required to be solved. Other questions are there in book, so you need to solve those, all the questions, each and every question by this way. Next you have, find the HCF of the numbers in each of the following using the division method. Here you need to use your division method. Before what we did in question number this 1 and question number this 9, this was prime factorization method. Now we will do the same thing by using division method. So how it is done, you see, you have 58 and 70. 70 is required to be divided by 58. So just you see, you know how to divide. So this will go one time, 58, you subtract this, 10 minus 8 is equal to 2, 6 minus 5 is equal to 1. Then again what remainder you have got, with this remainder, this divisor is required to be divided. So here you write 58 and divide this. So this will go how many times? 12, 5 is 60. So 12 4 is 48. Now you subtract, this you will get 0 and 1. Now again remainder you have got. By this remainder, this divisor is required to be divided. 12, 10, 1 ja 10, you got 2 as remainder, and again the same repetition will be there till you are not getting remainder 0. So by 2 this 10 will be divided, so 2 5 ja 10. Now you have remainder 0, nothing means remainder 0 you have. So in this case this will be your HCF, this number what you have got, this will be your HCF. So any other questions if you will be having, the same process will be required to be applied till remainder you are not getting 0. So therefore you will write, therefore HCF of 58 and 70 is equal to 2, and this will be your answer. So in this way other questions are required to be solved. Let's see next question what we have. The same thing is there, by division method this is required to be found out, your HCF is required to be found out. The same method will be applied, division method. How we will solve, you see. See, take any two number, either these two or these two or these two, any two number you take, and first number, bigger number is required to be divided by smaller number. So we are taking these two numbers. So here you see 2, 3, 4, 6, this is required to be divided by 1, 7, 9, 4. Here you see, if 2 times we will take, 17 to the 34, it will be too large. So, 1 time it will go 17, 9, 4. Now, you subtract this, what you will get? We are subtracting this, you will get 2, 14 minus 9, 5, and 12 minus 7, 5. That is it. Again what remainder you have got, with this remainder this number is required to be divided, 1794. So here you see 2 times it may go, or 3 times also, 5 3 ja 15, try 3 times, 3 2 ja 6, 3 5 ja 15, 1 you have, 3 5 ja 15, and 1 16, yes. Then you subtract 14 minus 6, 8, 8 minus 5, 3, and 7 minus 6, 1. Now you see 5, 5, 2. How many times it will go? 4 times it may go. 4, 8 ja 32, 4, 3 ja 12, and 3, 15, 4, 1 ja 4, and 1, 5. So now you have got remainder 0. So in this case your this divisor, last divisor, is your HCF for these two numbers. So you can write HCF of 1794 and 2346 is equal to 138. Now what you need to do, this HCF what you have got, this number and the last number what you have remaining, you need to find out HCF of these two numbers. So let's do the same thing. Now you have two numbers, we need to find out the HCF of 138 and last number you had 4761. So the same thing is required to be done, 4761 divided by 138. Now you see how many times it will go. 3 times, I think, 3 8 ja 24, 3 3 ja 9, and 2 11, 3 1 is 3 and 1 4. Subtract this, 6 minus 4 is equal to 2, 7 minus 1 is equal to 6 and this is 1. Now, how many times? 4 times I think, 4 8 is a 32, 4 3 is a 12 and 3 15 and 4 1 is a 4 and 1 5. Now, you subtract 11 minus 2 is equal to 9 and you have 11 minus 5 is equal to 6. So, now you divide 138. So, how many times it will go? 2 times I think, 2 9 is 18, 2 6 is 12 and 1 13. So, now you are getting 0. So, again in this case your HCF is 69. So, finally, for these all three numbers you will be having HCF. You can write hence HCF of first number you had, you had 1794, 2346, 1794, 1794, 2396 and the last number was 4761. So, that will be 69, 2396 I think that number was there. 2346 it is, 2346, 2346 it is. So, 1794, 2346 and 4761, the HCF of these three will be 69 and this will be your answer. Okay, next question we will see. Here you have, show that the following pairs are co-primes. You need to show these two numbers what has been given, they are co-primes. So, what are co-primes? Co-primes are the numbers, they may be two composite number, two prime numbers, one composite and the other prime, but they must not have any common factor other than one, and those type of numbers are called co-primes. Any two numbers which are having no common factor other than one. So, here you see how will you know this no common factor is there, you need to factorize this. So, you factorize 343, you see 7, 7 4 is 28 and you will be having 7 9 is 63 and 7 7 is 49. 4 3 2 you factorize, what you will get? 2 2 is 4, 2 1 is 2, 2 6 is 12, 2 1 is 2, 1 you have, 0 you will put, 2 8 is 16, 2 5 is 10, 2 4 is 8, 2 2 is 4, 2 7 is 14, 3 9 is 27 and 3 3 is 9. Now, you just express these numbers as their prime factors, the product of their prime factors. So, this will be 7 into 7 into 7, it means 7 cube. Next number you have 432, so this will be 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 3. So, it can be written as 2 to the power 1 2 3 4 into 3 to the power 3. Now, you see you do not have any common factor, here you have 7 cube and here you have 2 to the power 4 into 3 to the power 3. It means they do not have any common factor other than 1 and that is why these both numbers will be co-prime. So, you can write clearly 343 and 432 have no common factor other than 1 and therefore these numbers are co-prime. This will be your answer. So in this way, if any other questions are there, what you need to do, first you need to factorize both the numbers, then you see common factor is there or not. If common factor will not be there, then both the numbers will be called co-prime. Next you see, next you have find the greatest number which divides 615 and 963, leaving remainder 6 in each case. Similar question in solved examples we had last day already we had done. So in this type of questions, what you need to do, last day only I had made you understand. If suppose you have number 615 and 963, here you have to find out the greatest number. It means you need to find out HCF, which divide that greatest number by that HCF, or by that number if you are dividing these two numbers, you are getting remainder 6. Here what you need to do, you need to subtract this 6. So if 6, the remainder would not come, means exactly that will divide this number. So you need to subtract this. So you will write, since remainder is 6, therefore, we need to subtract 6 from each number, both the number. Here you see 615 minus 6 is equal to what you will get, 609, and 963 minus 6, what you will get, 13 minus 6, 7, and 5 and 9, 957. Now you need to do what? You need to find out the HCF of these numbers. It means HCF of this number will divide these both number exactly, and with the same number, if these numbers will be divided, remainder you will get 6. So you need to find out HCF of 609 and 957. So by any method, by prime factorization method or division method, you find out. So by division method you find out 957 is required to be divided. 957 is required to be divided by 609. Okay, let's divide. This will go one time, 609. So 17 minus 9 is equal to 8, and this will be 4. 9 minus 6 is equal to 3, and this will be how many times it will go? One time, 3, 4, 8. Subtract this, what you will get, 1, 10 minus 4 is equal to 6, and 5 minus 3 is equal to 2, and then 348, how many times it will go, 1 time, 261, 8 minus 1 is equal to 7, 14 minus 6 is equal to 8, now 261. How many times it will go? 3 times, 3 7 ja 21, 3 8 ja 24, and 2 26. Now you got remainder 0. So in this case, your HCF is 87. So what you will write? You will write the HCF of 609 and 957. HCF of 609 and 957 will be 87, and therefore the greatest number greatest number, the greatest required number, you can write the greatest required number will be 87, and this is your answer. So now what HCF you have got 87, by this number you divide those numbers, initial number what was given, and check that is true or not. You had 615 and 963, so by 87 you divide these two numbers, you will get remainder 6. Okay, next you see, reduce each of the following fractions to the lowest terms. Again the same thing is required to be done. What you need to find out? You need to find out the lowest term, it means HCF of these two numbers. So by any method, again by any method you try to find out HCF of this. So either by prime factorization or division method. So if you are factorizing this 161, if you are factorizing 161, how will you factorize? Suppose this 6 and 1 7 and 1 8, so by which number it will be cancelled? By 7, 7 2 is 14 and 7 3 is 21. If you are factorizing 207, you will get 2 and 7 9, it means by 3 it should be divisible, 3 6 is 18 and 3 9 is 27, 3 2 is 6, 3 3 is 9. So 161 can be written as 161 can be written as 7 into 23, and 207 can be written as 23. So this 23 and 23 will be cancelled, you will be left with 7 by 9. So now no other common factor you have remained. So this is the lowest term or reduced form of 161 by 207, and this will be your answer. So in this way, if any fraction is given, you need to factorize that. By any method you need to find out the HCF of that, and by that HCF you cancel that common factor and you will get the reduced form. Next question, you have 3 pieces of timber, 42 meter, 49 meter and 63 meter long, have to be divided into planks of the same length. What is the greatest possible length of each plank? Here you see, try to understand. If suppose 3 pieces of timber you have, suppose this is your timber like this. So one piece, that length is 42 meter. The other piece what you have, that is of 49 meter, and the longest one you have, that is of 63 meter. Now 3 pieces of timber you have of this length, 42 meter, 49 meter and 63 meter long, have to be divided into planks by the same length. You need to find out the planks of the same length. What is the greatest possible length of each plank? So greatest possible length of the plank you need to find out. So again you need to find out the HCF of these numbers. So you find out HCF, we need to find out the HCF of 42, 49 and 63. So it is better you by prime factorization you do. So factorize 42, what you will get? 2 2 is 4, 2 1 is 2, and 3 7 is 21. 49 7 7 is 49, 63 7 9 is 63, and 3 3 is 9. So 42 can be written as 2 into 3 into 7, 49 can be written as 7 into 7, and 63 can be written as 7 into 3 into 3. Common you have only 1, that is 7. Common number is 7, and therefore HCF of 42, 49 and 63 is equal to 7, and therefore what is the greatest possible length of each plank? Therefore, the greatest possible length of each plank will be equal to 7 meter, and this will be your answer. So, in this way you need to find out the plank, the greatest length. So, you need to find out the HCF of these numbers. So, in this way, if other questions also are needed to be solved. Next question you have, determine the longest tape which can be used to measure exactly the length 7 meter, 3 meter 85 centimeter and 12 meter 95 centimeter. So, again the same thing is required to be done, you need to find out the HCF of these numbers. So, here you have 7 meter, that is meter centimeter. So, in one means either that you convert into meter all the numbers or you convert in centimeter. So, if you are converting centimeter in centimeter, suppose 7 meter can be written as 700 centimeter. This 3 meter 85 centimeter can be written as 385 centimeter, and 12 meter 95 centimeter can be written as 1285 centimeter. Now, by any way, either by division method or prime factorization method, you need to find out the HCF of these three. Here you see, we need to find out the HCF of these numbers 700, 385 and 1295. So, by prime factorization you can find out 71 is 7, 0, 52 is 10, 500, 54 is 20 and 22 is 4. 385 can be factorized, 57 is 35 and 57 is 35, 71 is 7, 71 is 7. Then you have 1295, 5 to the 10 and 55 to 25 and 59 to 45. Then you have 73 to 21, 77 to 49. So, now these numbers can be expressed as, here you see 700 can be written as 7 into 5 into 5 into 2 into 2, and that will be equal to 7 into 5 square into 2 square. Next number you have 385, that can be expressed as 5 into 7 into 11. So, no repetition of number is there. So, 7 into 5 into 11 it can be written. Next number you have 1295. So, it can be written as 5 into 7 into 37. Again, no repetition is there. So, it can be written as 7 into 5 into 37. Now, you see which number is common in these three. So, first number you have 7 and second number you have 5. So, in these the least power of these two common factors are, so HCF will be what? 7 into 5, 5 and 5 square you have, least power is 5. So, this is 5. So, finally, you will get 35. and you had converted into centimeter, so this will be 35 centimeter. So hence the longest tape or the required number, simply you can write, hence the required length will be 35 centimeter, and this will be your answer. So in this way, these type of questions are required to be solved. Next, you have find the HCF of two prime numbers. Here you see, you know what are prime numbers. Prime numbers are the numbers which are having only two factors, one and the number itself. So any two prime number you take, suppose any prime numbers you take, suppose you have taken 2 and 3, can be taken 5 and 7, can be taken 11 and 3 or 11 and 13. So any two prime numbers you take. Now you need to find out HCF of this. So HCF of 2 and 3 will be what? So how will you find out? The factors of 2 will be 2 into 1, and factors of 3 will be 3 into 1. Common factor is what? 1. So HCF of 2 and 3 means no common factor is there, it means 1 is there. So HCF of any prime numbers, two prime numbers, will be 1, and this will be your answer. Here you see two consecutive numbers, any two consecutive numbers you take, 2, 3 you take, or 4, 5 you take, 20, 21 you take, or any two consecutive numbers you take and find out the HCF of these consecutive numbers, what you will get again? You will get 1. How? See, this already you have seen, 1 you are getting. Here you see 4 and 5 does not come in same table. So again, if you are factorizing 4, 4 into 1, 5, 5 into 1, common factor 1. Here you see 20 and 21, suppose 20 can be written as 5 into 2 into 2 into 1, 21 can be written as 7 into 3 into 1, it means again what common factor you are getting? 1. So any two other examples also can be taken. So any two consecutive numbers if you are taking and finding out the HCF of these, you will get 1. So HCF will be 1, this will be your answer. Okay, next you see any two coprimes. Coprimes are the numbers, any, just now I had told you, coprimes are the numbers that they may be two prime numbers, two composite numbers, one prime and the other composite numbers. So if they don't have any common factor, then they are called coprimes. So write those numbers. Suppose 2 and 3, these both are prime numbers, or 2 and suppose 1 prime and 1 composite. Suppose any composite number you write, that is suppose 33. So 33 can be written as 11 into 3, it means this is composite number. So any prime and composite number you have taken, or 2 composite number you take, suppose you have taken 33 and 24. So both are composite numbers, 33 and 24. Now you see common factor, what you will get? Here you will get common factor 1. Here again you will get common factor 1. You factorize this 33 and 24. 33 if you are factorizing, you will get 11 into 3 into 1. 24 if you are factorizing, you will get 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 1. Again, what common factor you are getting? 1. So if any two coprimes you are taking, and their HCF will be one. Next you have two and an even number. Two you have, any even number you take, suppose you have taken 20, and suppose you two and any other even number, suppose 12, any other even number you take. Common factor, when you will find out, two can be written as 2 into 1, 20 can be written as 2 into 5, Here you see 2 into 1, 12, 2 into 2 into 3 into 1. It means what you are getting common factor? 2, 2 and 1. So, 1 will be factor of all the numbers, but here you are getting HCF 2. So, any number, even number you take and 2, common factor you will get 2, and that is why HCF of these two numbers means 2 and any even number will be 2, and this will be your answer. So, I hope most of the questions already we have taken. Many other questions remaining are there, that is just related to the your solved examples. So, by seeing those you can do, and even today's what questions we have solved, by seeing these also rest of the questions are required to be solved. So, try to solve each and every question in your notebook. Till then, thank you.